the jaguar that you've seen the pictures of, that's him. Call him Three Spot because he's got three spots on his forehead that line up just perfect.
We've been running this survey in the Belize Maya Forest since 2013 to put out remote cameras all over the jungle to photograph and match jaguars by their spot patterns. Their spot patterns are unique, so you can tell them each individual apart. And so that way we can track who's alive this year and eventually how many are out there, how long do they live, all kinds of really interesting things. That work primarily gets done back at the university. So we do a bunch of mathematical, statistical stuff to estimate population size and then keep track of how many jaguars there are, how healthy is the population, what are the drivers of cat densities over time.
Elevation is 92 meters.
Jaguars have big home ranges, so we have to have these remote cameras spread across a massive landscape. They're spaced 2.5 to 3 kilometers apart, and we have hundreds of camera stations. They're up for about 3 months. We check them about every 10 to 14 days. So it's a constant cycle of finishing the camera checks and then restarting them until the end of the survey. Probably the main challenges are all related to just covering such large amounts of area on really bad old roads or making new trails to get into places that don't have roads.
Trees fall down all the time. You go out and you think it's gonna be a quick just drive and get to your station. And then meanwhile, the jungle has other plans for you and having the machete for hours.
You know, we're chainsawing for, you know, a solid hour. You know, we're all sweating. Move with the tree fall all the way and I keep going. And next thing you know, we get stuck. If we can't get it out and we're by ourselves, we're hiking back to the village.
When you're out there working all day and you're chainsawing and you get really tired and then you finally get to your station and you're like, okay, this has been a rough day, and then you open up the camera and you see, like, right where you're standing, there was a jaguar there, like, a day ago, or five. We even have where you pull up and they were there, like, 5 minutes before you, and it just makes everything worth it when you get to see that.
Want to see what we got? Let's look at the pictures first. Left, maybe.
You're constantly excited to see what you got.
Turkeys. Turkey. Oh, skunk.
Nice.
Jaguar.
Puma.
And it's, like, a good feeling when you know animals are using the trail and you're getting all this data.
Wait.
No,
wait.
I think it's a jaguar.
Yeah.
Let me get a better. Oh, Puma next, but wait, let's go zoom. Oh,
no,
wait.
Ocelot.
Oh, is it an ocelot?
Yeah, it's an ocelot.
Oh, it's pretty. Not quite a jaguar, but I'll take it.
I've never had a moment where someone pulls up a cat picture, a jaguar, a puma, and I'm like, oh, okay, it's another picture. I'm always just like, this is the cutest animal, and I'm so lucky to be able to work on them.
I've been doing camera trapping now since early 2000s. Doesn't matter. Every time we get those cat pictures, it's like fantastic. It's just like so wonderful. Never gets old.
I think once people realize how important, you know, a jaguar is, or just the entire ecosystem is, and the benefits that they get from it, they actually realize, oh, we need to actually take care of this and preserve it for not just us, but our future generations.
For sure, the scientific benefits are great, but I always say we should care just because we're a part of this world. Like, we have a responsibility for this planet, and I want to protect the jaguar and the puma just because of their, like, intrinsic value.